Students will be discussing about interconnect summary. This is lecture number 10. So in electrical circuits, noise refer to undesired fluctuation in current or voltage that can directly interfere with a signal or indirectly degrade system performance by increasing delay or power dissipation. Noise in electrical circuit can be broadly classified under two primary categories: device noise and switching noise. Device noise is intrinsic noise of the device, while switching noise is induced noise due to switching activity of a signal. Switching noise is caused by signal transition, high to low or low to high transition of a digital signal. It is typically 2 or 3 order greater than device noise in most microelectronic systems. Therefore, switching noise coupling between digital circuits, referred as aggressor, and analog RF circuit, referred as victim, is critical. Switching noise is not strictly a random process, since this noise is dependent upon switching activity of circuit. Practically, switching noise can be treated as random phenomena due to several reasons. For example, a large number of nodes switching at different locations across a die, permitting cumulative noise to be characterized as random. Not only that, the time constant of each node is different, contributing overall randomness of the noise. Two types of switching noise exist: interconnect noise or crosstalk noise and power ground noise. Interconnect noise is subject to this chapter. We'll be discussing about interconnect noise. But before that, we'll also see what is device noise. So here we'll be discussing about noise, effect of noise, active passive device noise, capacitive coupling noise, inductive coupling noise, and effect of coupling noise. So what is noise? Students, in electrical circuit, noise refer to undesired fluctuations in current or voltage that can directly interfere with signal and indirectly degrade system performance by increasing delay and power dissipation. So there are two categories, as I told you: device noise and switching noise. So they are analyzed with a statistical model and calculated power spectral density. So if we see the device noise, there are three types of device noise. First is thermal noise, second is short noise, and third is flicker noise. So we'll see what is each one by one. So thermal noise, also known as Johnson or Nyquist noise, occur in a conductor due to random motion of charge carrier. This random motion is generated by thermal agitation of electrons that are in electrical equilibrium with a molecules. The power spectral density of thermal noise is therefore proportional to temperature and independent of frequency. The mean noise power per unit bandwidth is constant at all frequencies. So SVF is given as 4 kBTr, where kb is Boltzmann constant, T is absolute temperature, and R is resistance of the conductor. As NMOS transistor also generate thermal noise due to channel resistance, this noise is typically modeled as current source IN between source and drain node with a power spectral density as given as SIF equal to 4 kBT gamma GM, where GM is transconductance of the transistor and coefficient gamma is approximately 2/3 of long channel device and increasing as channel length decreases. Now, second category of noise, that is known as short noise. So in electronic devices, short noise refer to fluctuation in the current due to discrete nature of charge. As opposed to thermal noise, short noise is dependent upon mean current flow or bias current in a semiconductor. The power spectral density of short noise is given as SIF 2QI. And the last but not least, flicker noise. So, Flicker noise, also referred as 1 by F noise, occurs in semiconductor due to energy traps, which result in generation and recombination of charge carriers. The power spectral density of flicker noise has an inverse frequency dependence. So if we write the power spectral density, it is SI into bracket omega equal to K into bracket I raised to gamma divided by omega raised to alpha. Now here K is constant depending upon device characteristic, I is DC current, W is angular frequency, and gamma and alpha are exponent with typical value respectively. Gamma is 1 and alpha is 2. And between 0.8 and 1.2. The flicker noise of MOS transistor is modeled as voltage source at the gate terminal with a power spectral density SVF equal to K by W into L into COX into F. As we have already seen in the, we will see in the lecture more details. So now capacitive coupling noise. So there are three components of interconnect capacitance: parallel plate capacitance, crossover capacitance, and coupling capacitance. The increase in the aspect ratio TINT divided by WINT of an interconnect due to non-ideal scaling is also discussed. So now here see the figure. As described earlier, aspect ratio of interconnect increases due to technology scaling. As a result, the coupling capacitance starts to dominate. So if you see in the figure, as the distance is decreasing, the coupling capacitance increases. You can see here in figure 1, the capacitance is C1, and in figure 2, capacitance offered is C2. Now you can see here in the second figure, distance is decreased. As a result, your C2 is increased. So you can see here D1 is greater than D2. That is why C2 is greater than C1. So further we will see dependence of coupling capacitance on switching activity. So two capacitively coupled global interconnects are shown in the figure. The global interconnect represent a lossy transmission line are modeled as a distributed RLC impedance. The magnitude of interconnect coupling capacitance is dependent upon nature of signal transitions. So see the figure and see the table. So when interconnect 1 and interconnect 2, interconnect 1 is switching and interconnect 2 is not switching, at that time effective coupling capacitance will be CC and total capacitance of each interconnect will become CPP plus CC. When interconnect 1 and interconnect 2 are switching in phase, then coupling will be 0 and the interconnects are not affected by any crosstalk effect. So this is the requirement, right? We should arrange such that two nearby interconnects are switching in phase. So at that time, coupling noise will be 0. Now third case, when interconnect 1 and interconnect 2 are switching out of phase. So at that time, effective coupling capacitance will be maximum. Maximum noise will be there or crosstalk will be there. That is 2 times CC. So total capacitance to the interconnect becomes CPP plus 2 CC. So this is the worst case scenario when both are switching out of phase. And as a result, the current which is flowing to the victim node is given by the expression like this. You can see here it can be modeled like this. And the current flow IVT is given as CPP dVV by dt plus CC dVV minus dVA by dt. So here VA and VV is the potential difference across capacitance CC. So that much extra current is, charging current is flowing for this capacitance CPP. So this is your crosstalk noise.